Hola, what is up you guys? It's Anna. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Anna. I'm Latina. Today's video, as you can tell, is a hair tutorial. This is long overdue. Last time I did a hair tutorial, you guys, this is what my hair looked like last time I filmed a hair tutorial. Obviously, rocking a very, very different hairstyle. It's bleached, it's blonde, it's long. So obviously wanted to show you guys because you've been asking me lately on YouTube and on Instagram how I've been styling it. So if you're here just for the styling part of this video, I'm gonna leave a little text down here telling you when the tutorial starts. Otherwise, I wanted to talk about today's video sponsor. It is obviously hair related. My hair has grown a ton. It's been processed, it's been bleached, it's been toned, it's gone through so much. This is the first time that I've actually cared about what I wash my hair with. In the box that I received from Murray, I got two shampoos, one conditioner, a hair mask, and a hair growth spray. This is your entire hair routine. Thank you so much, Murray, for sponsoring today's video. These are the products I've been using in the last month. Is when I've seen the most growth and health in my hair. My natural hair is super dry and it's very, very frizzy, and I always struggle with this. I started using these and oh my gosh, I am obsessed with it. It is completely natural. This is paraben, fragrance, cruelty, silicone, SLS, and GMO free. Makes sense why I've been so obsessed and happy with my hair lately. It is, I mean, you can see it is so soft and so shiny. A big part of my hair care routine is how often I wash it. I've been washing it only once a week. Maybe twice a week, but I'm just really aiming for once. And every time I use the Mori shampoo and conditioner, depending how my hair is feeling, I would also do the hair mask. Out of all the products, this is probably my favorite one from them, because hair masks, again, my hair is super dry. This does wonders for my hair. I also have been loving their growth spray. This I've been spraying on my roots. I've always had a lot of scalp problems, flaky and dandruff. This stuff helps so much. I think it's because of the ingredients in it, but it's really, really been helping at keeping my scalp happy and healthy. And oh my gosh, it smells. It smells like a spa. It smells so freaking good. It doesn't keep your roots oily or dirty. So again, because I don't wash my hair often, it's really important to try to keep my hair as clean as possible so I don't have product buildup. This stuff, it does not do that. And obviously, once I wash it, the shampoo is perfect to cleaning my hair but not stripping it from its natural moisture that it needs. It does not leave it frizzy. It's just magical. I love it so much. I've just been very scared about what I put into my hair. Again, because it's treated, it's bleached. And this is a brand that I can 100% trust. It's color safe. It's actually helping my hair grow healthy and happy. I no longer take supplements to grow my hair because I feel like using these products is all I really need. And as you guys can tell, my hair has grown so much. It's bouncy, it's shiny. I think it's the best hair I've had in a while. I used to just lose hair left and right. But the thing is, I have always had thick hair. It's probably because I'm Latina, it's a Mexican in me. Thick hair comes natural. It's just one of those things where, like, all over the house, my little hairs are everywhere because it's constantly falling. And I noticed one ingredient in this shampoo that I haven't tried before in any of my hair products is caffeine. And I did a little bit of research, and turns out that caffeine helps a lot with hair growth and hair loss, which explains the results that I've been seeing. Just thought I would point that out. Again, that's a very unique ingredient that I've never tried on my hair before and has been amazing. Once again, thank you so much to Mori for sponsoring this portion of the video, and now let's jump into the hair tutorial part of it. So, how have I been styling my hair lately? It's a technique that I recently discovered. I watch a ton of hair tutorials here and there. I watch my stylist do my hair. I watch other people do their hair. And I actually came up with this combination of a little bit of everything that I've seen in order to get this hair, which I just love the shape of the wave because it starts here. It also gives me volume. I love how bouncy it is. One of the things that I've been dying to have is these front money pieces, and I was finally able to grow my hair out enough to get them done. And I feel like this style also is just super flattering to these money pieces. You guys know I'm not expert in hair, so if I'm able to do this in under 15 minutes, you totally are going to achieve this. So let me show you. Once my hair is dry and straight, I will go in with my curling iron. I think it's really important to start with straight hair. If your hair is curly, I definitely recommend straighten it out, blow drying. I love the Revlon hairbrush. That's my favorite thing in the entire world. But it definitely, like, you have to have a straight base in order to get this really cool look. Otherwise, you know, your roots are gonna be curly, your ends are not gonna be straight. But now for the curling wand. If you guys have watched any of my hair tutorials, you probably know I use this one all the time. This is my ultimate favorite curling wand. I literally pulled off my Amazon purchase. I got it in July of 2019. I've had it for 2 years. It's the only thing I use. It is a Babyliss Pro Nano Titanium or something like that. It's a 1.25 inch. This one works with every single length I've had so far. You guys, I had hair this short, I even had that weird little shag. This is probably the longest I've had my hair. It's the perfect size always, so I highly, highly recommend this one. I'll link it in the description box for you as well. And I usually don't need touch-ups because this curler just makes it last. Now for the actual technique, so what I do is I split my hair in half, line going down the middle, right side, left side, and I do like to work in parts because I don't curl my whole head the exact same way. Here's what you need to know. The bottom part, it really doesn't matter how you curl it. It just has to be somewhat wavy. One thing I do like to mention is that I do not curl the ends. So I'm gonna grab my curling wand. I'm gonna make sure I leave some room at the end, just like my ends, leave them alone straight as is. Curl up. I always like to curl all towards the same size. Clip it, roll it, leave it for a few seconds. I don't like to leave it too long because again, we're trying to do much of a loose wave, and then undo it. I like to pull on the ends because this also kind of emphasizes the straight ends that I love so much about this look. Like I mentioned, I have a lot of hair. So my bottom layer is actually 2 layers. So what you're gonna watch me do next is exactly the same thing as I did right now. I would say from your ear down, so like from here down will be your bottom layer and this will be your top layer. So here I'm doing the exact same thing. I don't go in and curl nowhere near closer roots because I don't want to add volume just yet. If I start adding volume from the very bottom layer, my hair is going to be incredibly poofy and weird. Just curling or giving a little bit of a wave towards the mid length and doing the same with the other side. Now moving on to our top layer. The technique that I'm going to show you is what's going to give it this bouncy look that we all have been loving. And you guys have been asking me how I do it, just that little wave from the top going down. So we're still curling all towards the same side. You're gonna clip your hair, but this time, because it's a top layer, we're clipping it from the root. You're gonna twist once and leave your curling iron right there. Wait a few seconds. You're gonna see me kind of unravel, but I'm not unclipping, I'm just unraveling. Still clip, pull it down lower, leave it there just for a few seconds, unroll, and pull straight for those cute little straight ends. At first, it definitely is a little bit tricky because I know when I started doing this I was a little bit confused. I was like, wait, where do I turn? What do I do? It's just a matter of practice. So let's do it one more time. Oh, I haven't mentioned this already, but in this whole hair tutorial, it does not matter how thick or how big the pieces that you're grabbing are. It's all about the messy cute look, so don't worry about how much hair to grab. So we're gonna grab the curling iron, grab it as close as you can to the scalp without burning yourself. You're gonna twist it once, so make a full twist and hold it there for a few seconds, and then you unravel it. Don't open though, just unravel, pull down towards the end, twist your curling iron again. Now here's where it gets a little bit tricky for me. As you know, I had bangs. It's been a little bit tricky to curl them, which is why I also haven't made a tutorial recently, because honestly, I would just tuck it under my ears and be like, that's how I used to deal with it. But now that they're getting longer and that I got these money pieces, I'm obviously able to curl them. What I do on the front pieces, I like to split my current bangs into two. The one that's further back, that I'm gonna do the same technique that we just watched, curl from the root. And this one, since it's such a short hair piece, I don't need to unravel and curl the next part, because once I twist it once, that's truly all it needs. This whole hair look is about having the ends straight, even on the shorter layers like this one. We don't need to curl the ends, so just twist it once and let go. But again, if you don't have short growing bangs, you don't have to worry about that. And I'm gonna do the same to the other side, split my bang section into two. The one farther away from my face, gonna twist only once and let go. And now for the actual very front pieces. This one's a little bit more tricky, but it's the same technique. All you have to do is you have to keep your curling iron constantly moving, because we don't want any intense curl. So you're gonna do the exact same technique from the root, except that you're not gonna stay still and let it curl. You're just gonna keep the movement going and even go over it twice if you need to. So you're gonna grab the front piece, clip it from the root, twist it, but keep twisting it. Don't leave it there. And unravel, pull down, and that's it. Once my hair is completely cooled down, I like to go in with my fingers and kind of break up the waves so they're not super stiff. It's really important, at least for my hair, to wait until they're completely cooled down. Otherwise, these would not last as many days as they do. So I just comb through it like that. And because this is the first day, I don't really like to put product in it. And because of the technique that we use on the top layers, it's got a lot of volume and it's bouncy on the top. Usually after sleeping with this hairstyle on the first night, maybe the second night, that's when you'll actually need maybe some texture or volume spray on your roots. But one thing I do use, and I use this every single day, is any sort of hair oil or serum, because like I mentioned, my hair type is really, really dry and I like to do it all over my hair while doing that, also scrunching it a little bit. I'm not gonna lie, this hair is my favorite on second day hair. I always feel like the first day is a little bit too polished, but yeah, I usually throughout the day, the thing that I do the most is scrunch up the roots like this. And this is it. This is the finished look for the hair. I love it. It's so bouncy. I don't know, there's something so special about it. Ever since I found this technique, I do it every single day because I'm obsessed. Like, how cool does this hair look? And that is it for today's hair tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope I was able to explain how I do it. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. Once again, thank you so much for today's video sponsor, Mori. I'm going to leave links in the description box for everything you saw in this video, including today's sponsor. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you guys. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any new videos. I would love to have you guys join my little family. Si eres latina o latino y estás viendo este video, déjame saber en los comentarios de dónde eres. Me encantaría saber de dónde son mis otros latinos. Yo, si no sabían, crecí en México, vivo en Estados Unidos y pues sí. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.